Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Nikolai Palok, Java developer advocate at Oracle, and today we're going to talk about faster and more secure inter-process communication with JDK 16's Unix domain sockets, even on Windows.
Just one topic?
I knew it! Jose spoiled you! I asked him to hold back, but oh no! He decided to totally upstage me and come out with four topics! Remember that one time when I was proud I had three? Four. That man. Unbelievable. So to compensate, we're gonna just have one topic today. Ready? Then let's dive right in. Java Socket Channel API provides blocking and multiplex non-blocking access to sockets, which you can use to communicate between two services. This used to be limited to TCP/IP sockets, but since Java 16 it's also possible to access Unix domain sockets. No, not like that. Unix domain sockets are addressed by file system path names, which comes with a few advantages and a considerable limitation, more on that later. They are supported on Unix-based operating systems like Linux and macOS, and despite their name, since Windows 10 and Windows Server 2019. Let's take a look. As mentioned, Unix domain sockets are based on path names, so the first thing we need is a path instance. Twice actually, once on the server and once on the client, both pointing to the same name. We can then use the path to create instances of Unix domain socket address. The next step is to prepare a server socket channel on that address. For that, we call the static factory method open with the new enum value standard protocol family.unix. Then we can bind the server channel to the address and start accepting incoming messages. On the client, we need a socket channel. Note, not a server socket channel, just socket channel. It also has a static factory method open that we pass the same Unix protocol enum to. Then we connect it to the address. The two classes, socket channel and server socket channel, have existed since Java 4, and what kind of socket they use to connect makes no difference in how messages are passed between them, and so message passing across Unix domain sockets works exactly the same as with TCP/IP. That means it's a bunch of low-level input-output stream or even byte buffer fiddling that I'm gonna spare you here. Compared to TCP/IP connections, Unix domain sockets have the considerable limitation that they only work on the same host because the client and the server need to access the same file system path. Note that this does not prevent communication between containers on the same host as long as you create the sockets on a shared volume. If you are on the same host though, you get a number of advantages over TCP/IP loopback. First, because Unix domain sockets can only be accessed from the same system, opening them instead of a TCP/IP socket has no risk of accepting remote connections. Second, access control is applied with file-based mechanisms, which are detailed, well understood, and enforced by the operating system. And third, Unix domain sockets have faster setup times and higher data throughput than TCP/IP loopback connections. So if you're doing inter-process communication on the same host, maybe between Java code and some native app, I highly recommend to check out Unix domain sockets for more throughput and security. Then I got two shorter pieces of news for you. First, JDK 17's first release candidate that Jose talked about in the last newscast didn't need any changes, so it's now the final release candidate. That means unless it's a hair on fire emergency, there will be zero changes between now and September 14th. And second, Oracle Developer Live will take place on September 14th for the Americas and September 16th for the rest of the world. It's a free online event all around Java innovations. If you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description. And that's it for today on the Inside Java Newscast. If you have any questions about Unix domain sockets, ask ahead in the comments below. And if you enjoy this kind of content, help us spread the word with a like or by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues. I'll see you again in 2 weeks. So long!